they're going to be dropping a series anytime in the near future. Obviously, that happened here against BMG yesterday. And again, this is not a team, though, that's just going to roll over and, you know, get emo about it, I guess is what I'm getting at. Just be like, oh, well, now life sucks, by any means. So I'm sure they're going to give – that would be pretty depressing. But, no, they're going to be fine in that sense. So that's where, for Don's sake, you know, I'm kind of curious what they think about this matchup, whether they would have wanted BMG or Sync Esports. But in the end, as Tankafet pointed out yesterday, you know what? You go into any matchup thinking that at least you have a chance to win, because if you don't, then you might as well not even play the match, right? So, but yeah, excited. The big thing, though, for me has to be the fact that ProBusk, especially going up against, in a sense, his former team before he was with Reason Gaming. I mean, it's been a while now, but he was part of Sync Esports. Eventually, you know, things just weren't working out, whatever, and eventually was dropped from the team. So I'm sure there's something there as well, as far as especially wants to make a point here in Cycle 4. So. God, that's exciting. But what about this draft, man? I mean, this is already an interesting start here. We got Parasite, Cthulhu Font, Swiftblade, and Rhapsody were the bands. Picks coming out to be Ophelia and Keeper on the side of Dawn. Can't say I'm too surprised there. Magmus Tempest coming out for Sync. Here we go.
Yeah, and I guess we talked about the jungle meta like the other day. Actually, we had obviously Tankfit on the interview afterwards, and he sort of saying a similar sort of stuff as what we were talking about in the cast. But yeah, but I mean, we're flying through the draft. Each team knows exactly what they want. Fill up with a Kraken for Dawn and Pebbles for Zinc. Then, I mean, we talk about Kraken players, but Labyrinth, I mean, he's had a great showing off the last couple of games, and I mean, Zinc, they should be definitely afraid.
Yeah. It's one of those. Now, it should be afraid, but at the same time, you know, again, they have practiced against this many times before, it's safe to say. And, you know, I'm sure they're going to be ready to obviously face against it. But, yeah, it's safe to say, Don, this is their go-to. This is what they like to do. Now, they do finish off the Kraken as well, yeah. So the fact that Don even got their hands on Kraken, I think you could have expected. If they didn't pick up Kraken, I wouldn't be surprised to see Sync picking up Kraken for themselves, in fact. So they get Kraken for themselves, in fact, for Don. And, you know, they end up with Pebbles in the end for Sync, you know, nothing wrong with that there, Mickey. I'm sure we'll enjoy that just fine. But safe to say, and I think if I'm not mistaken, Kraken is actually Sync's go-to hero right now as far as their win percentage. He has the highest amount of wins and still being undefeated in the end. So a very comfortable hero for Sync Esports. You look at the bands coming out here: Pyromancer, Malakin, Glacius, Torturer. Again, though, really keep an eye on the carry style. Malakin, not surprising, especially with this Ophelia Keeper combo. They love to run the Malakin. But obviously there are other ones on the board, specifically that Silhouette. Are they going to address the Silhouette here? Hell, they had to go against Zibe Silhouette yesterday, and that obviously didn't work out in their favor. So I want to think they're going to ban Silhouette with their final ban, but we'll see.
Yeah, I think you should, though. I mean, the hero is incredibly strong, and ProBus has showed time and time again that he can play incredibly well. And he's a great sort of superior stopper as well, because obviously the tree bowler Tree Bolas, yeah, is actually superior. He's physical, so it's going to go through Tempest Strong and Heads, going to go through Pebble Strong and Heads as well. And I mean, it's a great hero, particularly against sort of these big team AoE fights, because you know she can sort of split push, she can be quite hard to really get lock under control, and she can really just be such a pain in the ass, honestly, with her shadow as well, because she can just be very, very hard to catch. So yeah. I think we will most likely see a ban on it. I mean, one hero that has actually been banned already is the Malakin, and we saw ProBus absolutely dominate with that. So,
yep, that's that is for certain. Now, Don, I mean, a lot of extra time coming out here as far as the bands go. Again, this is a huge, huge match for really both these teams. Not often we see that for Sync, more so because of where they're usually at. But again, here they are in the losers bracket finals for the first time here once again in season three. So definitely kind of new territory in that sense. And that's, I guess, you know, I'm sitting here saying how, you know, I doubt they're going to really let it phase them too much, but they haven't been here. I mean, with this roster, they have not been in this situation where they've been in the loser's bracket. They have to be playing from coming from behind, really, in this sense. Now, we've talked about before, you know, teams like Stay Green, the best of teams, they had to do it several times throughout season two. If you remember, you know, they drop it in the loser's bracket, eventually would have to come back to the grand finals and win it in the end. So Sync couldn't really show, like, what kind of team they are, in a sense, with a performance here today. At least that's what they're going to be aiming for. Now, Aluna, the final ban. That's a very interesting ban from Dawn. I mean, Aluna's not a hero we see nowadays.
But, I mean, if you actually look on the hero pool, there has been an absolute destruction of sort of bans on onto support. You've got Glacius, Torturer, Rhapsody, and even Pyromancer that's been banned out here. Soul Steel is one of the one bans that isn't to do with a support. And, I mean, for Zinc, their options are a little bit limited outside of maybe the Empath or Witchlayer, which, I mean, they haven't run Witchlayer in ages, but I remember when I think it was the first cycle of Haunter, I think we saw a lot of Witchlayer come out from supports because of that burst potential. It's a great hero to combo up, but they pick up Empath, so I mean, for Zinc here, there is no top support outside of Engineer, of course. That is the one here I completely forgot about. And I guess Engineer Magmus can work perfectly. So.
Yeah, it's like...
A lot of team AOA.
I know, the fact that Engineer was like... He's used to be regarded as obviously even a god tier, but he did get a couple of nerfs, and now, you know, not as adamant about picking him up. But still, I mean, he's a fine option. I think that they could be pretty satisfied getting him. I mean, especially with that Empath, I don't see anything but Silhouette here, right? I mean, it just makes so much sense.
It has to be hard. Yeah. I mean, they even right-click it here. I mean, it has to be Silhouette. I mean, I can't think of any other hero that could really work well with it. I mean, Kraken can 1v2 quite fine. They go Doctor of Pulsar.
Really?
I disagree with it because there's a lot of there's a lot of magical kind of presence from Dawn already kind of thing, and they need some raw damage, and Silhouette is going to offer you that, whereas Doctor of Pulsar isn't going to really be that useful. Like, because you're going to have Shrunken Head picked up by Pebbles, you're going to have Shrunken Head picked on Tempest, even Shrunken Head on Magnus perhaps, and when they pick up Silhouette themselves, and yeah, I just, unless Dawn do something, you know, quite radical in that sense in terms of like big team fights and big pushing, then I don't know how they're really going to face off, because once Zinc pick up their Shrunken Heads, I mean, there's not much physical presence here on Dawn, and I think they're going to get overrun by Zinc, but we'll have to see.
You know, this is one of those cases where after this game's over, we definitely need to look back to this, what just happened right there. The fact that they consciously chose to pass up Silhouette, a hero that Probusk has been playing fantastic on, a hero that owned Sync Esports, to be frank, yesterday, being played by Zibbe, and it just seemed like it would have made a lot of sense here. They chose to go with Dr. Repulsor, and sure enough, Sync picks it up for themselves, as you're pointing out. So, I mean, I'm looking at that, and it's just like, okay, Don, I mean, you guys made this decision here. Not pick it up, but allow them to get it. So will that backfire is the question now.
Yeah, I mean, to me, there's like, where's the damage coming out from Dawn? Like, Aphelia is not going to give you any damage. Empath not going to give you any damage. Keeper's not going to give you any damage. It's going to be Kraken and Doctor Repulsor. And even Kraken doesn't do too much unless he gets a lot of farm. Like, you pick up Empath to sort of completely, you know, steroid the carry. And Doctor Repulsor just isn't one of those carries that can really benefit from Empath. Yeah, obviously Empath can benefit any kind of, you know, core hero. But at the end of it, like, it's a Doctor Repulsor compared to a Silhouette with an Empath inside. Like, you're going to pick up Silhouette every single day, and Silhouette can definitely out-carry Doctor Repulsor as well, and to me, Dawn just, they kind of have a sort of a time limit on this draft, and I don't know.
Yeah.
Guess we'll have to wait and see. I mean, if Probusk can get a lot of ganks off and can get those early rotations with the Doctor Repulsor, something that really Silhouette can't do on the early levels, then maybe it's going to be useful, but I just sort of see Dawn sort of sitting back farming when, you know, Zinc will be happy with that because they've got the superior late game in the end. They've got obviously Tempest, Engineer, Pebbles, like all have a great, you know, utility in terms of the late game. But then you've obviously got the hard carry and Silhouette as well. So Dawn, they've definitely got to have a key strategy going into this game with the draft they picked up, to say the least.
Yeah, so really, again, it's Probusk getting his hands on Doctor. Now, has Probusk played Doctor yet? I mean, Quincy, would you be able to hook us up with that stat? Because, I don't think he has. Like, I mean, obviously, we haven't casted all their games by any means, but...
It just doesn't feel that, like, it doesn't feel like a Dawn hero to me.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's also that Empath synergy. I mean, Doctor's not a hero that's relying on, the move speed increase, the attack speed increase even. It just, again, where on the other hand, obviously, Silhouette really is. You know, Malekith really is. So, it's almost something. Part of me wants to say, like, Labyrinth was like, you know what, this is too obvious. It just doesn't feel right. Let's go something a little different. But sometimes the obvious is the best.
Yeah, exactly. And I think also, I think they were scared of Dr. Repulsor being picked up from Zinc, honestly, because Dr. Repulsor would have worked quite well, actually, in terms of Zinc, because Dr. Repulsor can be very, very, like, hard sort of catch. And, I mean, Dawn don't have the greatest sort of way of dealing with Dr. Repulsor if Zinc picked it up. Zinc had kind of the late-game presence with Tempest and Pebbles and even Engineer, sort of the late-game, whereas, you know, Dawn, they couldn't have really dealt with the Dr. Repulsor, as for Zinc, they could have, so... I guess they sort of took Doctor away from him, but, I mean, whenever you're sort of picking, just sort of taking away from the enemy team, it's a little bit awkward to me.
Yeah. Well, you know, it wouldn't be a true competitive match in a series without a little bit of a pause here to start things off, so Hey. We delayed things even a whole hour yesterday, obviously, because of with a night raid having to ask him for a later start. But today is kind of interesting too. Obviously, you know, with the time now, technically the match wasn't delayed today. It was just simply because of the time change in Europe and not in North America. So it's at the same time in Europe at 1800 Central European Time, just after the time change. But in America, here it's actually an hour later for myself. So for the American crowd, so 1 p.m. Eastern, of course. What we're looking at here. So, not that I expect that to really have any impact in the end. An hour time change for these teams, but definitely worth noting there. Of course, coming in next weekend, America will actually change their time as well, and so everything will be back.
Oh, really?
There. Yeah. It's really stupid how it works. Don't ask me. I don't know.
I don't even know why we do it.
I'm sure there's logic for it somewhere, but.
What did you do an hour later, though? Oh, I'm sorry, a week later.
Like, exactly, I don't know. I'm sure science has a reason for it, but
science.
I don't know off the top of my head. So that's that. So yeah, Mickey, it looks like he's going to be rebooting here, and then we'll be good to go. But yeah, that is a fair point that you bring up about maybe they with the doctor just simply, if anything, to also take it away from sync. But you know, using your final pick as almost like a ban in that sense in itself is kind of like, I don't know if that truly is your best option. But at the same time, I mean, now, you know, so we're really analyzing that last pick specifically. But, I mean, overall, Dunn does, again, have their keeper Ophelia, very strong combo that they love to run. I mean the lanes here, I mean, are we expecting anything too crazy, you think? Or?
I don't know, because I obviously thought the Doctor Repulsor was going to be like a silhouette, and in that case I thought it was going to be an empath and silhouette bottom. But now with Doctor Repulsor, he can handle himself in a sort of 1v1 matchup, so we might see an empath crack in mid. But against an engineer Pebbles, I mean, I think that's going to be able to destroy empath once, you know, Pebbles and engineer get like level 3 or level 4, because empath just doesn't offer that much in terms of a dual lane, really. The only time I used to sort of see an empath dual lane work was when, you know, Drunken Master was on the scene quite heavily, and now obviously after the recent nerfs, or I wouldn't say recent nerfs, but after the nerfs he just fell out of favour, and so did empath dual mid, but we'll have to see. I mean, one other sort of reason why we might have saw Dr. Repulsor as well, I mean, it is quite decent against Engineer, because obviously when he ulties, he doesn't actually get the purge. If he, you know, ulties into or out of Engineer field, he doesn't, because he's obviously invulnerable when he ludicrous speed, but out of that, it's like there's not too much synergy outside of that. But
that is fair, because that actually does bring up a good point too about Engineer against a silhouette, for that matter. You know, because the illusion actually, you know, clear those out pretty quickly, so it can cause issues there too. So maybe that was also kind of a thought process, seeing that Engineer pick up a support that we don't see as often nowadays. Perhaps something to do with it. So. Yeah, again, we're obviously getting plenty of time to analyze it because of the pause here, so it's probably a case, like I said, of getting the point, maybe overanalyzing it, and we'll see how it plays out here in the end. But Mickey has reconnected, just a matter of if everything is actually going to be good to go here. And advance
on. We're seeing Keizu Magmus actually on the suicide lane as well. That's, to me, is a little bit peculiar. To be fair, like, I mean, obviously he plays a great Magmus, but normally we see like Swiftblade, Warbeast, like even Kinesis the last time. Magmus, I don't think he's played too much Magmus Suicide. I don't know what kind of stats we've got for him, but it's just
like,
weird.
Yeah, I feel like, I mean, Magmus Suicide in general really isn't as popular nowadays as far as suicide options go. He really,
outside of Fuzzy Sloth, like,
yeah,
he's not the only hero.
Yeah, I feel like, yeah, though, again, he really hasn't been played as much as we did see it for a while there. So, you know, I'm sure Casey is definitely on that as well. Okay, so he actually has quite a bit of games.
Five
this
games.
Season.
Yeah, not one of the losses, though.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, they team that doesn't have many losses. We were talking about that yesterday especially. I mean, they were 28-4 going into the BMG matchup. So I guess math would make it 29-6 after. But, you know, again, the important thing with that is that they lost a series for the first time. Keep on stressing that, Al. This is their first time being in the loser's bracket. So, again, kind of seeing how that may ultimately phase them here. As far as that's concerned, though, all five off the bat. Here we go, Sync.
This is a scary.
Yeah?
This is a scary for level one team. Now, there's so many stuns on the team, but they're going to get spotted out by the keeper minions, so. Good play coming out from Yellow Rexar in that respect. But yeah, I mean, we're not going to see something too crazy. We're going to most likely see sort of suicide Magmus, engineer Pebbles mid, and short line silhouette. We do actually see one of the hard camps actually has been blocked, actually, and very peculiar kind of ward of sight actually here into the Legion jungle. I guess to sort of spot the affiliate rotations so Keizu can be fun. I mean, sometimes we sort of see this ward here placed more to the right side, like over to the, you've seen the lane, like the left side of the lane, but sometimes if you're really, really quite pushed up already, if you see affiliate on the left side of these trees, then it's always too late. So
yeah.
I guess putting it over here is just giving you that extra sort of time to sort of spot out any rotations. But it looks like actually Keizu is going to pull the lane, which I think is a very, very good decision actually, because it's going to be a dual lane, and you know, it's Dawn, they're not even expecting it, and he's got boots as well, so he should be fine.
Yeah,
he's going to get a lot of early experience actually, and a lot of early gold.
Yeah, I mean, Empath, and I was going to say a support play to Empath. Obviously, that's not the case here at Hugo Bic, but still, Empath can be decent in situations like this if he gets a good wall off on the correct angle, but it looks like he's going to try to get over there, but or see maybe happening and realizing, okay, can't get there in the end. So, well played by Keizu. And, making the best of that situation right there, as you mentioned, with the boots first even, so. Suicide Magmus, indeed, is what it's going to be. Ooh, kicks down middle, missing right there from Insania. Yeah, that's kind of funny, because he almost expected Labyrinth to at least react a little bit, but Labyrinth just literally stood there. Plus, the kicks down actually just missed him, so.
We do actually see Empath in the bottom lane, then, so they're going to dual lane the Doctor Repulsor, and it's like, to me, like, obviously, dual laning with Dr. Pulsar is fine, and actually, he's going to lose one of his melee creeps, which is kind of a big deal, honestly. Like, and he's lost two, actually, is what that's like a real big hamper, actually. Like, if you lose two creeps early on when you're sort of getting dual laned in a. Oh, man. That pull from Kaze has really screwed them over.
But, yeah.
Just going back to the Dr. Pulsar getting sat by the Empath, like, to me personally, if you're ever running a hero that can easily handle himself in a solo matchup, when you're running it dual lane, to me it just seems a bit of a waste for the support, because you know, Dr. Repulsor will most likely get the same kind of farm whether Empath is here or not. Like, he's going against a Magmus, he's going to do fine 1v1, and Empath being here is just a little bit of a waste, but at the same time he can't support mid because he's going to get absolutely destroyed. So again, in terms of the draft, it's a little bit awkward coming up from Dorm.
Yeah,
not really being that efficient in that respect.
Well, make do, and again, Probusk, hero especially, player especially, and again, really, Dawn does seem like they just value that 4-1 strategy, as we go back to as well. One of the only teams to do that nowadays. It doesn't seem like that is as prevalent as maybe, I guess that was never really a thing. There's just always been maybe one or two teams that have kind of been popular with that, and again, Dawn, for the time being, happens to be one of those teams, really just making sure Probusk especially gets the farm. And that's definitely what they're going to go for here, I'm sure, not being anything different. Now, double damage rune was picked up by the middle lane right there. Looks like Engineer, so he's going to have it coming back on a Kraken. Extra Kraken, oh, it got the charge off in time. Probably still would have been fine, but it would have been a lot more dangerous if he actually got caught there initially. So, does survive in the end, despite the pressure attempt being put out there. So, yeah, now the lane control a little bit better here for Dr. Repulsor. You do see Empath kind of chasing around Magmus. But again, Magmus having those boots, I mean, he's able to get some good distance here and make it pretty difficult for Empath in the end to effectively harass him. So, there you see Magmus going to fall back, going to be fine. Dr. Repulsor in a solo lane, only 3-6, but in a dual lane, 9-4. So, yeah, it's safe to say Doctor, when he's babysat, as a lot of carries would be, the same case, sure. More successful than when going in that solo presence, as far as the stat line.
That seems a really weird, though, stat for me, to be honest. Because, I mean,
You there? Mini?
Sorry, I accidentally muted myself.
Hate when that happens.
So I was just like going back to, that stat seems so strange to me, though, because, like, if you can solo, if you can 1v1 without any kind of help, then it's going to free up another support to help the rest of your team in the other lanes. But I guess, the only thing I could say is that they're going to get a lot more kills, obviously, if support is bottom. But here comes Magnus as you rotate in mid, and Kraken might be in a little bit of trouble, actually.
Huh. Now, I don't know if it's because of the lane positioning or whatnot, but he's playing this in kind of an interesting spot here. And actually, nice job with the hatchet, actually, to snipe that last creep. And it's level 5 with that, too. So, yeah, Magnus
so
waiting around, but unfortunately not going to be able to go in. And, just not worth the initiation. Yeah, already nearly 800 life at this point.
Yeah, like, I don't know if they could even kill him with Magnus as well. But Magnus and Empath going at the bottom lane. But
uh-oh, Empath? No, she's going to be fine. Yeah.
And actually, Empath isn't the greatest zone of support against Magmus either, because he can completely disjoint the Essence Link when he uses Lava Surge, because obviously it just makes him invulnerable, and the Essence Link just gets completely sort of worn off in that respect. So, and that's why we've seen a level 3 Magmus here. But he's trying to rotate mid because he's not going to get any farm against a dual lane, and once Dr. Pulse gets level 6, then he's going to be absolute food here for Dr. Repulsa. But,
yeah.
But look at his form, though. It just seems so low. And I mentioned the two creeps he missed in the early levels, and it kind of is a big deal, honestly, because two creeps would have made him like 30 or 40 GPM higher. Like, if you compare that to sort of Mickey in the middle lane, he's like 360, and that like 4 CS more than him, but not the biggest of deals, I guess, but just something to be noted.
Well, I will say this. I mean, as far as comparison, comparing to the, you know, counterpart carry, he is actually doing slightly better with that set. You know, 330 gold per minute, Silhouette about 300 here. So still even with the starting now, Silhouette is going against Keeper of the Forest, a hero that's definitely going to be abusing that pull mechanic, of course. In this case, Yellow Rexxar playing it. So maybe a little bit more understandable there. At that point. But yeah, Magmus, I mean, other than that initial play that he made, you know, doing the creep wave pull, now he's actually, he's almost doing a little bit of a jungle thing. He's actually going to be heading towards the top lane even, looking for any kind of opportunity to make something happen right here. But
yeah, and it's the right play to make, because he isn't going to get anything in the bottom lane. Like, Doctor and Empath are just going to absolutely destroy him if he even sort of creeps up in the lane. He's going to actually try and kill this Keeper of the Forest. If they've got Tempest on, they've got Dust on Tempest.
Yeah, they're going to be going in. They're committing to this. There's the stun in. Dust comes out, so Envy is not going to be effective. He still gets the armor buff, of course. It's going to mitigate plenty of damage. Going back to the tower, trying to tank long enough. Will he get any kind of support? Nothing just yet. Health potion going to be used, though. Another Dust comes out, making sure to see him, and he will get killed when it's all said and done. So, took a lot longer than expected, sure, but they do get it. Flensmeister getting credit for the Bloodlust. Again, this early on in the game, probably wouldn't expect TPs to be happening, so.
And, I mean, no one can really rotate over. Like, the only person you can maybe arguably say you should rotate over is Dr. Repulsa, but, like, he's not going to leave the top lane, like, just for one Keeper of the Forest. Like, Aphelia can't rotate over. Empath doesn't even have any money, and Kraken is just, like, what, he can't do too much without a portal key in that respect. And so it's just a good dive current from Zinc, and now they're going to take the T1 tower. So Keizu, I mean, he's just having a lot of impact in this game, even though he's got no kind of farm because of that one rotation. So, well played coming out from him.
Yeah. Was indeed, and all of a sudden, so much for Dr. Pulsar having the better time here early on. I mean, he's still having a great time, and it is going up and up. 375 gold print now for Doctor, but obviously Silhouette really looking good. 460 GPM here coming out for Flensmeister. And, you know, we've talked about Flensmeister because of just how the team plays in sync. They don't usually rely on him. Speaking of almost like the opposite here, where Don relies on Probust to be that hard carry and get as much farm possible and take over the game. Zinc, not as much. They rely just on teamwork overall, and, you know, we'll see games where Flensmeister happens to be third, if not fourth, highest GPM in the game just because of the role in the hero he's playing. Now, again, what I'm getting at this game, I feel like he definitely should be top farm if they're going to be looking to be successful, of course, playing a hero like Silhouette, and especially with the start he has. But we'll definitely see how that actually develops here in this game. But you see, again, though, Probust, though, making the best of it, 366 gold per minute. It does drop down, Kraken is slightly there, but Pebbles being at nearly 400 GPM himself is going to prove to be a big factor, obviously, in this point.
And this Keeper has just got absolutely nothing in the lane. Yeah, I know he was in the suicide lane, but he was 1v1, and he's been absolutely dominated by Flensmeister. Like, Yellow Rexxar has had kind of no impact in the lane, and yeah, obviously his laning presence has been nerfed, but he can still see us quite easily because of the amount of actually middle lane.
Yeah, initiation here in the middle. Pebbles actually going to be gone. I'm release Kraken in the background, trying to lock them down. Not the best place, but the charge will finish off Pebbles right there. Magnus and Engineer going to be fine. So yeah, release the Kraken. Not sure what exactly happened there, but didn't necessarily get the best positioning with it, but they got the kill, and now the push is going to be happening here. 15 seconds more and counting here on Pebbles for the resurrection. So they're going to go for this. They got to be a little bit careful, though, because with Pebbles coming up, no doubt he can TP in. However, Silhouette and Tempest are pushing the top lane. And right now, Tempest actually out of mana. No, he does have mana for a TP, but that would be it. Silhouette does as well, but again, she would be low. So something tells me they're just going to kind of give this up here in the middle. In fact, initiation in the background. Skeletal King comes in. Engineer going to be locked down. Engineer very likely going to fall as a result. Yes, he will. Pebbles did what he could, but couldn't do much else for the time being. And tower goes down. So overall, Dawn actually coming out pretty well right there as far as that middle fight exchanging going on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I think they weren't really in a good position to sort of fight that, and so instead of trying to split push, they might take that tier 2 top. It is going to get invulnerable. Keeper is rotating over. He does have a root, but it was the right play to make from Zinc, though, because, I mean, Pebbles is already down. They didn't have any mana on Engineer either or Tempest, so they did the best trade they could have done and at least put some kind of pressure onto the tier 2. Not the biggest of deals.
Yeah, they get that here. Keeper of the Forest, though, is here to kind of start pushing it back. You do see the tower, though, at about 280 life. So, yeah, that's a good point. Sync definitely was making somewhat of the best of that situation exactly. But in the end, again, Don should overall be fairly happy. I mean, they had about a 2,000 gold lead on Sync after that top tower especially went down. And now you look at it's back to being pretty much even here because of what happened there in the middle. And now you see these more team support items starting to be coming out. Plated Greaves finished on Keeper. You have, of course, the Ring of Source around Ophelia into the Astrolabe, which is going to be coming up shortly. And now Dr. Pulsar, you know, 1230 gold saved up. Doctor, again, though, one of these interesting, especially on a player that we don't see him played really ever, in this case with the ProBusk, what should we expect to see as far as items are concerned? Oh, now, give the Force, meanwhile, the top rune, yeah, he's going to be picked off. Eruption used, Dust came out, and down goes Keeper. So well played right there to pick him off. But what do you think,
Doctor? Going back to ProBusk, It's kind of a little bit of a hard situation because he obviously needs some kind of regen. Like, he could go for Nullstone, but to me, it just seems a little bit of a wasted item. There's nothing that's really going to stop it. Obviously, Keizu isn't going to be a bad play, and clicky stun onto ProBus. He's obviously going to click on the floor, so that's not going to impact the Nullstone. The same obviously with Pebble's Chuck as well. So Nullstone, in my opinion, is out of the options. He could actually pick up either a Grimoire or some kind of Icon. Grimmer is a little bit greedy, but Icon, he's not going to get a lot of charges because they're not going to be really ganking in that respect. She's middle lane.
Yeah, middle lane. They're going to be initiating right here. Root came out. Pebbles. The lockdown, will it be enough, though, overall? Dr. Pulsar's trying to fly around. He's already pretty low in mana, though. In comes release Kraken, but so does the energy field. Charge out from Kraken. Keeper the Force is going to be picked off in the end. Pebbles barely alive and will stay alive, it looks like, for now. In fact, shuts away Doctor to finish off Kraken. Now Dr. Pulsar going to get locked down. The keg stun connects. In comes Silhouette with the auto attacks. And a double tap for Flansmeister. He's looking for a hat trick. Very likely going to get the third kill right here, as yes, it will be a hat trick for Silhouette when it's all said and done. The initiation in the first place, somewhat questionable perhaps, and Sync was ready to fight it. They also get the tower, and it's fights like that where Sync Esports, if they're going to take it, you know, that's going to be the start of a long journey now for Don to start coming back here.
Yeah, and I mean, it's big. Honestly, I love the pickup of Magmus in this draft. Like, they had so much early aggression, so much more sort of presence in terms of the early and mid game, and in this sort of, do we pause or something? Or
yes.
Right. I didn't see it. It was like lagging out. I thought it was like lagged out or something. But yes, I mean, this Magnus Pickett, although, you know, he hasn't done too much in terms of his lone lane, like, he's got 5 assists. So he's been in nearly every single kill. And it's just perfect for the kind of the play style of Zinc here, because they've been getting so aggressive so early on. And these early engagements is all what it's about. They took, obviously, the tier 1 middle because of the sort of rotations coming out from Magmus. And I mean, normally we sort of see more of a passive suicide here for Keizu, you know, the Swift Blade, like the War Beast, but this you know, this Magmus, this early aggression is really sort of suiting Zinc's sort of playstyle here, and it's really paying off. Because I mean, look at the golden experience lead, nearly 5,500 gold, nearly 4,500 experience, and Zinc putting in a lot of work actually. So Dog's going in mid.
Oh, he tried right there, and unfortunately not able to catch them. So I was going to say, Silhouette obviously has a Nullstone finish with the Ghost Marchers. Flunsmeister Star continues to be very, very effective. And like I was saying, you know, expected to perhaps be on top GPM this game, and definitely is there over 500 gold per minute. Now, Dr. Pulsar, he actually went the Neophytes book, by the way, and it looks like he isn't sure enough going for the Lightbrand into what you would expect to then be a full Dawnbringer. And again, that's always just one
just a little bit
more
greedy.
Power, excuse me. That's what I meant. But yeah, exactly. It's just always, I've always found it to be one of those kind of greedy, like, does that make the most sense kind of items on a Dr. Pulsar? But
it's just hard, though, because, I mean, he could obviously go for the Icon, but he can't really take use of it. Actually, bottom lane, talking of Dr. Pulsar.
They're going to try to go for the jump. Well, they had to use quite a bit.
Damage,
but
man.
Yeah, I mean, in the end, they do lock him down. This time they're making sure that he wouldn't get away, so well played.
Kill secured. But, yeah,
does delay his portal key, too, by the way.
That is true, but I mean, going back to the sort of items you can go for, like, if he goes, middle lane, actually, there's so much action going on. I think he's most likely to be dropping as well.
Get the heal off? No, energy field comes out to secure it, and actually, they're going to pick off the minions as well, so yeah, extra.
That's the biggest
beneficial
deal, honestly, for Ophelia. Like, it takes like 1.5 minutes to sort of grab all the creeps you actually need for Ophelia, so a lot of downtime here after that death. But just going back to the Doctor of Pulsar, though, like, the Icon is, yeah, he could use it, it's a good item, but is he going to really be able to, you know, utilize the sort of hero kills and the sort of gank potential that the item provides? And I just don't think it is, because who's he going to gank with? He's not going to gank with Ophelia, he's not going to gank with Keeper of the Forest, you could definitely gank with an Empath, but is that enough? And Kraken without a portal key isn't really too useful in terms of ganks in that respect. But I mean, the biggest thing for Dawn here is that they need to prioritize this portal portal key on Kraken, because without it, they don't have any kind of initiation really outside of Dr. Repulsa, and they just don't have the team fire. Like, if you look on Zinc, they've got the portal key on Pebbles, and that's such a big advantage at the moment, and it looks like Zinc are going to try and actually push it.
Top lane, Keeper of the Force is going to be if he opens right here, they're probably going to go on him. Eruption is ready to go. The second, okay, they just say screw it. They know he's here. Dust comes out. Here goes the eruption. The trigger grapple. Ophelia's touch comes out, but it's not nearly enough. Meanwhile, in the middle lane, actually, Empath also getting picked off by Pebbles right there. With happens to have a double damage in that portal key, of course. So, yeah, Sync just really continuing to keep that momentum going. 7,600 goalie now, 7,000 experience lead. And Don just doesn't have a lineup that screams, okay, yeah, we can persevere through this and eventually come back. This is definitely built more around the idea of get the good farm with Doctor, get the early team fights going, the push going, have a solid start, and then work off of that. So the fact that they're behind early on is not good news at all right now for Dawn. Yeah.
And it looks like it's portal key gaming here for Zinc. Like, yeah. They've got three portal keys now, Tempest, Magmus, and Pebbles. And probably Engineer and Silhouette are going to pick up one as well eventually when they get the farm. So, like, five portal keys here on Zinc. And, I mean, it's the reason why, honestly, these kills are happening coming out from Zinc. And, I mean, if you look at on Dawn, they have no initiation outside of Dr. Repulsa. Like, Labyrinth doesn't have his portal key yet. And without that, I mean, how can they really initiate team fights that are really beneficial here for Dawn? Because they've got the pushing potential. Actually, Engineer might be getting caught, actually.
A little greedy right here, running through the Legion jungle by himself. He probably deserves to get picked off, to be honest, as Insania will fall there eventually. Really all five heroes even in the vicinity, making sure to take out that Engineer. So, but with that said, I mean, while that's happening, Silhouette continues to push top. You got, of course, Pebbles continuing to farm the bottom lane a little bit.
Yep.
He's going to kind of fake fallback right now. But
space created, man. Space
yep.
created.
Exactly.
But there's the biggest thing for that, though, is that they've got Portal Key on Kraken now. So whenever Zinc starts to sort of rotate, sort of start a push, you know, Dawn can now actually defend. But there's another Portal Key on Zinc now, so four Portal Keys. And they can just jump on one person, just completely blow them up. And that's going to be like a 5v4 in terms of team fight. And Dawn, they do have the Astrolabe and the Aphelios Touch, which is the only kind of sort of heals and sustainability, which is going to be very, very important against the burst potential here from Zinc. But I mean, for Dawn, top lane, actually.
Yeah, they jump into the force again. Hell, he's even going to root right there. He's going to go for the TP or even for the turnaround. Dr. Pulsar comes in, a pretty good initiation right there. Magmus actually dropped low as well as Silhouette. Silhouette's committing for the kill, though. Does she ever illusion up? She does not, actually. So she's still going to chase right here. She wants to kill. Kraken comes a beautiful charge coming in, but that's an illusion now. So she did have her illusion out. I didn't realize that. And in the end, she will actually be fine, of course. Meanwhile, bottom lane, Zlap picks off Ophelia down here with the assistance of Insania. So when it seemed like Dom might have had a little bit of an opening right there to start somewhat of a comeback, he actually makes the escape, as a Silhouette definitely can do. And eventually is fine at the end. So, I mean, Don, sure, no reason to concede yet by any means, but they're going to need to capitalize on those moments is what it comes down to, because they're not going to get many of them in the end. I mean, Grimoire is getting closer to being finished on Doctor with that said, so I guess that's almost like the good, like, the yeah. fact that they are so far behind, the fact that he is going for more of a hard farming item in a sense, probably for the better, but
what is Grimoire going to do, though? It's not like, oh my god, you know, Dr. Repulsa has Grimoire now. It's just not a scary item, and I mean, they need a lot more outside of what they've got at the moment, and actually, Ophelia's minion is going to be picked off again. That's honestly, again, another big deal. Skeleton King dropping, but I mean, look at Zinc's sort of lineup now. They've got all the portal keys they could, you know, hope for, maybe one on Engineer as well, but he's got his phase boots for some kind of initiation in that respect. And I mean, the team fight and AoE central here for Zinc is just, it's too much for Dawn to really handle. They don't have the items they need. They probably need like a resto on Keeper. They need a Strong and Head definitely on Dr. Repulsa, because without Strong and Heads, they're going to get absolutely destroyed in terms of the team fights. And Dawn, they've got a lot of ways to get back into this game.
Yeah, they do. Magnus striding towards the middle lane. He's looking for a chance here, possibly. I mean, he's got the Eruption, obviously, ready to go if he gets some kind of support. Ophelia and Doctor, though, by themselves currently. I mean, they're making a push to the middle, but, yeah, that's what I was going to say. If they keep going, this might be silly for them, as with only the two of them especially. So they are going to kind of split off from here and look for possible chances elsewhere, but yeah, Keeper of the Force, and when it comes to Suicide, wow, below 250 gold per minute. Suicides in general. Okay, I was going to say, he's actually been played that many times, but Silhouette is going to be picked off here, most likely, yep. So there you go. Again, Donna, they need that to happen. C- couple more times, you know, another needing to fight to go their way, and then perhaps they are still in this game. But
that's true. But I mean, the traits here from Zynga just completely on point, and maybe it's because they obviously they lost the last series against BMG yesterday, but every single team decision here coming from Zynga has been absolutely perfect. Okay, they lose Silhouette top, that's fine. They take a T1 bottom in trade, and the golden experience just doesn't even change because of the amount of objectives that Zynga are getting. And I mean, yeah, obviously they're quite upset that Silhouette died, but I mean, they're definitely, you know, be happy to sort of take a T1 as exchange for it. And now with this kind of map control as well, obviously they've got the Hellborn advantage, but they can easily take Conger as well. And Dawn, they have no way of really contesting it. They've got the portal key on Kraken, but I mean, without the kind of initiation from, you know, Keeper and Ophelia, like, I just think Zynga are going to be completely outmatching him in terms of any kind of Kongor team fight in the next up and coming 5 minutes. So yeah. For Dawn, I mean, they need, honestly, there's a few things they need. They need Hellflower or Sheepstick on Dr. Repulsa, but that's a very, very long way away. They need the Strongen head on him as well, because he's going to get incredibly sort of blown up by all the burst potential here from Zynga. And they could even get a Strongen head on Kraken, but all these items, they're just too little, too late, honestly, Breaky.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, getting that Grimoire again will enhance and ideally work towards something like that Sheepstick or Hellflower, but yeah, exactly. Will they have that window? Will they have enough time to make that happen? You talk about the Portal Key Gaming over here on Sync Esports. Yeah, four to the five heroes. Wouldn't be surprised if Insania, once he gets that gold saved up, definitely going to be going for one himself. So potential for all five heroes on this Hellborn side already with four of them, having that Portal Key, that jump chance to really just catch you completely off guard. So Don is going to have a little bit of time here, obviously, with this pause break to kind of talk it over and see what they can maybe make happen. But it really, again, it just keeps going back to just delay the ultimate push from Sync Esports here. And by that time, for Doctor to maybe get to somewhat of a scary point, but
yeah, but the scariest thing, though, is that I think Zynga even have the late game as well. So what are Dawn really going to be sort of delaying for? Maybe, yeah, they can find a small window in terms of maybe Strongen head picked up on Doctor, Strongen head picked up on Kraken, and that's maybe where they can find the timing before it gets too late in terms of Zynga and Silhouette being too strong. But that window is incredibly small, and even then, it's a hard decision to sort of show that they can get back into the game, but there's still a chance to break in. There's still a chance.
There is. And again, especially with this being the loser's bracket finals, absolutely no reason to just throw the towel this early on, but that's not going to help things either. I feel like it's picked off, and again, the minions, at least one or two are going to be picked off. Looks like just one in the end, but Ophelia as well, just constantly being locked down, constantly being jumped here. I mean, both Ophelia and Keeper, of course, have not really had any bit of the presence that you would hope for, and that's definitely been a big part to, unfortunately, why Dawn is where they're at right now. You see the chase kind of continuing, but in the end, it looks like they might be fine. Maybe Magmus is going to stun in? No. Keeper of the Force gets the invis off, and we'll be fine right there. But while this is happening, once again, Silhouette's been doing this plenty, as he does actually back to the bottom lane. There is the jump. Keeper of the Force going to be jumped. He couldn't get the root off. As out comes a release crack, and they were hoping that it could get the root most likely to maybe go in right there, but he wasn't able to. I mean, though, Silhouette wasn't with them, so that could have been a chance, but
just look at that burst potential. Like, you saw Keeper overextends just a tiny bit, and then just gets completely exploded on, though. They've got portal keys on Magmus, Pebbles, and Tempest, and, I mean, Keeper got only 1,000 HP practically, and just not enough to survive the burst. And talking of Keeper, he's had, honestly, a terrible game. 0-5-0, had absolutely no impact in the game, and I mean, you could maybe say that Yellow Rexxar hasn't had the greatest of games in himself, but Keeper of the Forest, I mean, there's been no way they can really get involved in the game. They haven't really been pushing in terms of Dawn because Zynga have had the control of this game from start to finish. So there's no way that, you know, Keeper could have really been involved in the game. They haven't been pushing with Ophelia Keeper, and that's the reason why you pick it up. So Zynga completely taking out the strategy here coming out from Dawn.
Yeah. Ooh, portal key away, making sure to not have an initiation. Again, a case of, I mean, Silhouette is not down here, so you can definitely tell Dawn almost wants to try to make something happen, knowing that Silhouette's actually pushing the top lane currently. And it's definitely for good reason. In fact, they're going to deny the tower. They're not going to try to bait it. Ophelia, though, by herself up here. She's going to get caught out. She heals up as much as she can, but simply gets picked off. So you got to really question that positioning. Now, they are going to initiate onto Pebbles right here. Silhouette is pushing the top lane while this is happening, though. Pebbles, he is going to end up falling. Root comes out as soon as Magmus jumps in with the eruption. So pretty good timing coming out right there. In comes the energy field, though, and the knockback. Keeper of the Force eventually going to be picked off. Great lockdown on the hand. Tempest, he hasn't even ulted yet this whole game. Hasn't needed it. Magmus gets picked off. And so really, you know, they get the fight somewhat in their favor. But exactly, while this is happening, Silhouette's like, you know what? Take out my team. I'm going to take out your melee racks. as he's going for that. So at least they clean up in the end. Will they save the melee racks? Actually, it looks like they are going to save the melee racks in the end too. So, I mean, I want to say for where they're at in this game, that wasn't the worst thing that could happen, definitely, but they still lost a lot out of it.
They actually were, I mean, they were actually high in terms of golden experience before that team fight, though.
True.
But they were actually around like 8,000 gold deficit now. They're actually nearly 12,000 gold deficit. And these racks are so easy to be sort of actually backdoored now as well. Obviously, the tier 3 tower is down, and Silhouette has just been sort of sitting up top. And I mean, Dawn, they're completely outstretched. They're completely outgunned if they go 5v5. I mean, it just seems every single option here for Dawn is just completely dim. But I mean, they are closing in on items that are going to be a massive factor, actually. The Shrunken Head on Dox Repulsion and the Shrunken Head on Kraken are going to be so big because it nullifies almost 4 out of 5 heroes coming from Zinc. The only one that's going to have an impact onto the Shrunken Head heroes here of Dawn is going to be Silhouette. And yeah, he's quite farmed 540 GPM, but he's obviously picked up the Null Stone, he's picked up the Portal Key, and all of these items aren't too much sort of revolved around damage. It's only the Firebrand, and he only hits for about 150, which isn't too much, seeing as obviously he's got the Keeper of the Forest armor buff as well. So Dawn, looking bad, but there's still ways to get back into this game if they can pull out some kind of big team fight with these Shrunken Heads coming out from Dawn.
Yeah, it continues to kind of be that storyline that they're just doing enough right now to still stay in this. Obviously, you know, it is only 24 minutes in the game. With that said, in fact, Dr. Pulsar, he's going to find Tempest right here, and that should be a kill. It will indeed. I mean, Empath inside Dr. Pulsar. So, and we talked about how Empath not usually the best synergy hero with a Doctor compared to others, but at the same time, I mean, she's going in hands no matter who she's in, obviously, and definitely beneficial in a Dr. Pulsar still. So, making the best of it there. Silhouette, she's pushing top once again. Now, her illusion actually being spotted by Kraken right here. So this is kind of that awkward thing. Now he's going to stun the illusion. He's going to pick it off. Now, did she swap? No, that's still the illusion. And that would have been kind of silly, obviously. So yeah, the real Silhouette is going to be fine. But I guess that's also what kind of makes it difficult. It's hard to tell now, especially that she takes, she has 100% life, right? I mean, she takes the same amount of damage as the real Silhouette would. So you can't necessarily tell if you're actually killing the real one or not off the bat.
Yeah.
Like you can with other illusions.
Yeah, and that's probably why it's so strong as well, because you can't tell, but he's level 16 now as well, so obviously does 100% normal damage and takes 100% normal damage as well. And I mean, I'm kind of surprised Zinc actually haven't tried to start taking Kongor. They could definitely do it. They don't have the greatest Kongor killing team because they don't have Abyssal, but they do have Ring of the Teacher, and they've got Astrolabe as well. And I mean, they're so farmed as well, so they could easily take Kongor if they wanted to. And Dawn, they can't really contest without the Shrunken Heads being picked up coming out from Dawn, but Doctor is very, very close, and if they can get that Shrunken Head, then there's definitely chances for Dawn to get back into this game.
Yeah.
Engineer actually picked up the Energizer instead, actually, which is quite funny to see. But it's good, though, because I think every team should have an Energizer because of, obviously, the movement speed burst. It's around 75 movement speed, so every team should have one, and it's obviously the sport's job to pick the items that the team doesn't have up. So.
Yeah. Yeah, again, it's like, I mean, part of me is like, everyone else has a portal key, and I almost want to say he kind of needs the portal key to keep up with the team in that sense, as far as jumping in. But at the same time, you are right. I mean, Energizer is obviously a, you know, good item to have, and you know that's more guaranteed to get, especially with the build-up, whereas saving up 2150 gold on a support, even in a successful game, can somewhat be difficult. So he gets the Energizer at this point. Wouldn't be surprised again, though, to see the portal key still to follow. Mickey, speaking of him with DC right there, going to try to fix that lag issue. But the Demonic Breastplate just finished on him, so another one of those items that, you know, good that they have it for multiple reasons, not only enhancing his own damage, but, of course, helping the Silhouette as well, especially. And you are going against the Keeper, as you mentioned earlier, who's constantly applying around that armor. What is that 8 armor now at max? No, 10 armor is the how much he applies at level 4. So throwing that around, what do you think of the Shrunken Head choice here on Dr. Repulsor? I mean, there is a lot of lockdown, a lot of AoE.
He has to have it. Has to. It's the biggest item pickup, honestly, that Dawn need. Because if they get Shrunken Head on Dr. Repulsor, then he can have such a free reign in the team fights. The only person that's going to stop him is a good Tempest Armor or Silhouette. And those obviously are hard to hit because obviously Kraken can stop, as well as Keeper of the Frost can stop Tempest Armors. And I mean, for Silhouette, he will have to focused on Dr. Repulsor. And Dr. Repulsor is such a sort of squirmy hero in that respect, so if you try to lock him down, then you're not dishing out the damage you can, obviously, with Silhouette. So, honestly, the Shrunken Head is going to be such a big pickup here for Dawn, and if there is one way to get back into this game, it's going to be Shrunken Head on Dr. Repulsor and Shrunken Head on Kraken. Because, I mean, outside of Silhouette and Tempest, I mean, there's nothing they can really deal with, actually, outside of the Shrunken Heads. They did obviously have the advantage going before the Shrunken Heads, but now, obviously, it's kind of going to be dwindling outside of the Shrunken Heads. So
yeah. All right, so it looks like it might be a little bit of a break here as he's going to go ahead and try to figure that out and, you know, do a couple things, obviously, on the technical side and try to get the individual lag set there. So, you know, it's it is the final day of Cycle 4, of course, for HON Tour Season 3. Definitely, Sync Esports, again, surprising to say the least that they are here in the first place here in what is the losers bracket finals, but deservedly so, as Bad Monkey Gaming was the better team yesterday as far as that matchup is concerned. And again, a lot of credit to the diversity, especially of kind of a different strategy than expected. We obviously interviewed Tankafed after the match, and you know, we talked about especially that Parasite and Keeper of the Force game that where they actually, in a sense, did a double jungle strategy, whereas Parasite's job was just 100% to lock down the Ophelia. And pretty much accomplished that throughout most of the game. It oddly enough, you know, that it actually didn't work early on, but as the game picked up and eventually all throughout the rest of it, I mean, he really did harass the hell
innovation,
at its left
man.
Lane, Ophelia. Exactly, innovation at its finest right there. So if you want to beat the best, sometimes that's what it takes, and Battlemike Gaming showing
it's
that right there.
It's always BMG that pull out the crazy innovation.
Know, right?
Like Devourer back in the old days of SG and BMG. Like, now Parasite, dual jungle.
That is true.
You met him, man. You're strapped.
That is true. So you can guarantee those Sync Esports looking for that rematch 100%. They are hungry for it. And, you know, showing that here is what is already game one, obviously, against Dawn at this point. So Dawn, though, it's kind of one thing to look at it where Dawn, you know, they're third place here. This would definitely be their best finish so far. You know, again, just getting diamond this cycle. They were before, but kind of in different roster. So a third place finish, not too shabby in itself. But, hey, you're here. You might as well, you know, try to play for even more. And, again, they were on the verge of defeating BMG in the semifinals. We keep going back to that, how, you know, if it wasn't for couple factors in that series, especially in that third game, that they could have definitely been the ones in that winner bracket final matchup against Sync in the first place, and then who knows how that would have ultimately played out. So, but they are here nonetheless, and again, feeling good about that at the first place, but at the same time, know that they can at least put up a good fight and perhaps move on even, and wouldn't that be something if Sync goes from winning the first three cycles to finishing third place in what is now cycle four. So, but we'll have to see. So again, hopefully not too much longer here before...
Oh, he's coming back. Looks like he's coming back anyway.
Is he? Okay.
I mean, one thing we didn't really mention too much actually in this game is the impact that Zinc have had in terms of the dual mid matchup. Like, you obviously had Kraken 1v2, and he got, you know, a sizable amount of farm and XP coming out for, obviously, when he was being solo, but... The fact of the matter is that when you have your early initiator with the most amount of farm on the team, I think Pebbles and Silhouette are around equal farm in that respect, is that you can dictate the sort of the pace of the game, and that's what Zinc have done this whole game, honestly. I mean, we had Insania on the cast the other day, and it's like, whatever team dictates that the play of the game from start to finish is the team that's going to win in the end, because you can obviously play your own strategy, you can play the way you want to, and it forces the enemy team to play the way you are, and whenever you're forcing the enemy team to do something they shouldn't really, then obviously you've got to take that massive advantage. And it goes back to the fact that, okay, yeah, if you're 1v2, you can soak up a lot of farm. You can obviously free up a lot of early farm on your hard carry. But, I mean, it's when you're going for the early mid-game sort of style of lineup, then it's always better to sort of focus farm on your initiator than it is your carry, because your carry is going to get the most amount of farm at the end of the game anyway. But look at Flensmeister, 540 GPM. Whereas if they try to focus Flensmeister farm and really sort of neglected Mikkei's farm, then they might not have had the greatest early to mid-game that Zinc are in now. So, to me, I just don't think Dawn have really focused their initiator enough farm in this game, and it is sort of paying, because they're 11,000 gold lead, and it's only sort of into the mid game, slowly getting into the late game, and maybe Dawn might switch up into the second game. But
yeah, that would be the idea. And again, I guess while we're still in this posture, I mean, it kind of ticks back to the what we were talking about at the very beginning, you know, the finish of the draft there. I mean, really, it's in a sense that although we were talking about it, ultimately it is kind of a hindsight thing. It's like, who knows how this would have played out if they did go Silhouette, and then sure enough, Sync would have got Doctor. But
yeah, I mean, I don't think it would have been too much of an impact. Honestly, at the start of the game, the two heroes that had such a big impact was Magmus and Pebbles. You got early farm on Pebbles, and then the rotation from Magmus, and with such a sort of passive early lineup, like Keeper, Ophelia, and Empath and Kraken, like, they can't do anything, you know, pre-10 minutes actually going in here.
Is that the real Pebbles? Oh my god, he's dropping fast right there. He does chuck in the last second, though. Is he actually going to survive? Dr. Pulsar still flying around. Gets that kill in the last second right there. Beautiful snipe onto Pebbles. And actually, you see Magnus and Engineer jetting on out of there with the Energizer. So yeah, coming right out of the pause. They had a game plan. And they executed right there. So sure enough, picking off Pebbles. And again, just those are situations that a couple more of those. Shrunken Head is finished on Dr. Repulsor. So
it's big.
That is huge. And going to help with the ultimate lockdown here of Sync Esports.
Yeah, I mean, I said it before, but I'll say it again, is that the damage here for Dawn, like, what do they have outside of Dr. Repulsor? Like, he's the only one on their team that has farm, and when the enemy carry has more farm than the carry that you're relying so much on, then obviously there is points where it's like, how can Doctor sort of, you know, put the team on his back and carry it? But we've seen time and time again that Probust can do it, so maybe it will be the same here.
Yeah.
We'll have to see.
Double stack Ancients on the Legion side. Let's see if when they get around to perhaps doing that specifically for the Doctor. Hell, even for somebody else, something like this crack and get his own Shrunken Head finished, or could be the Forest even, getting some more farm there. You definitely could use more farm around the Doctor of Ulster is what it comes down to, specifically on those two heroes. Hell, you look at Keeper of the Forest, really, I mean, that's just gone down, 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 man. 163 gold per minute here for what was a suicide Keeper of the Forest to start this game. So in the end, definitely wanted to recover on him. Silhouette, I swear, he loves his top lane, man. He just continues to rinse and repeat up here as far as pushing it up. But again, that's what Silhouettes especially can do. Not many heroes have the as powerful as a tool to do so. And you see right here, they're going to... Okay, that's the thing. It's like, for all they know, they're killing the real Silhouette.
I really disagree with the choice there from Probust. Like, the Skeleton Kings did not pop the Null Stone. That obviously shows that it's an illusion Silhouette, and yet Doctor wasted all of his mana. Like, that's a big deal, because now they're actually taking off Keeper of the Forest, and Doctor Frost has no mana to fight. Like, that's honestly a big deal, because if Doctor has mana there, he could easily get involved in this fight now. But just because they didn't recognize that was the real Silhouette, because the Skeleton Kings weren't popping the Null Stone of the illusion, Dr. Yeah. Pulse has no mana, and now Keeper's going to fall. And he doesn't have a buyback either, I think, after he dies. So the tier 2 could definitely be in danger. So a slight misplay.
And unfortunately, my screen be shaking here because of the
same.
Eruption right there. So I'm going to go ahead and switch the overlay over. So, it's unfortunate here. Obviously, you know, issues here for Mika coming out. So he is, at this point, kind of heading back to the well, so I wouldn't be surprised if he times out here. And the dangerous thing with this, though, is that I think we are running low on pauses now. We had a couple at the beginning of the game, and so I don't know how many we have left, but maybe 1 to 2 at the most between the two teams. So, you know, it's a case of hopefully whatever it is gets sorted out here quickly and can get that figured out before we continue to advance the line. But, yeah, as you mentioned, Keeper of the Forest most likely. Now, Ophelia's touch is up, actually. I wouldn't be surprised if Keeper lives here, honestly.
He's still dead.
They've used their burst damage. Do you think so? I mean, I don't know if he is, actually.
It's only Magnus and Tempest and Engineer, actually. You know, you might be right, actually. They don't have any kind of continual damage. He's obviously got the Nature's Veil, but, I mean, the eruption is still going off, though, I think. Like, it's only been going for, like, a couple of seconds, I think.
Well, I mean, he's going to get 300 life from Ophelia, so you factor that in. That'll put him, well, 650 or so.
Kraken is close, actually, as well.
Yeah, I don't know. I really think he's actually
going to be close.
Although,
Stun and Energy Field is up for Engineer. They're going to pop Energy Field just to secure the kill, and they should be able to get out.
Yeah.
We'll have to see, I guess.
Well, with that said, I think we might go into a short break right here. Obviously, we're getting to the point where we've had several of these pauses now, and rather than rambling on, we'll just come back when eventually the issue gets figured out here, and hopefully we'll be good to go. So, I'll let you guys know, or obviously we'll be coming back here. I'll keep you updated at the very least as far as what's actually going to be going on here. So, ladies and gentlemen, sit tight here. Game 1 of what is the Losers Bracket Finals, Dawn versus Sync Esports coming at you. Continuing with Game 1 here shortly. Stay tuned, guys. We'll be right back. Guys, welcome back. So again, unfortunately, we're still just trying to get this figured out here. Mickey obviously just having some technical issues as far as latency or the lag specifically. So hopefully not much longer. You know, we've unfortunately had to deal with this many times before in the past. Hasn't been too much of an issue as of recently, but hey, when it happens, it happens. So we're doing our best here. Obviously, I'll do my best, I should say, to keep you guys updated at the very least. Again, really no ETA, nothing like that, because simply we just don't know when it's going to get fixed. So, ladies and gentlemen, the best I can say is just stay tuned. I'll try to keep you guys updated as much as possible for looking at any changes here in the near future. So, sit tight. I'll let you guys know. Stay tuned, though, guys. We'll be back.
My trip. While I'm sitting the bar, cross streets of home. When your friend bartender just made drink for me. Yeah, I can see the mirror behind his back. And my reflection that is drinking Mr. Jack. I'm looking through the window to see the roadway. Everyone, the footprints are messed every day, dude. I'm feeling the same about myself. And I'm drinking for sleep because I'm happy people say it helps. Anyone can fix it, but nobody can see all the shit that will lie in the road we all need. Nobody cares, and I feel sick and tired. It's hard to clean up, so easy to be blind.
I wanna fly.
gone for me. What can I do? It is a people only. No, nobody can deal with that. But the third sip will make it not so bad. Bad. I wanna break myself, wherever the shame, somewhere else. Now my shift is gone to the bottom. Maybe next time I will change you, not change the pattern. Anyone can fix it, but nobody can see all the shit that will lie on the road we'll meet. Nobody cares, and I feel sick and tired. It's hard to clean up, so easy to be blind.
I wanna fly with all my design, time sweep the sky. Joy in the breeze, but even angels, if they come to help us, they will cry looking at this.
And now I'm sitting at the black bar, paying bill with my gold card. And I'm thinking that enough, cause this road has no end, it will bring me nothing,
nothing.
And I'm gonna go my own way, when I'm looking for my soulmate. I dress, go out, I see this mess and decide to go around.
We all want to sometimes reach the sky. Joy in the breeze, but even angels, if they come to help us, they will cry looking at this.
Oh my god, obviously, as you can see, we're back into the game here. I don't think my co-casters are with me, but Cupid does get picked off. They try to go for a turnaround. Unfortunately, it does not actually happen, though. So, okay, so it looks like, yeah, that's what I thought was going to happen. Okay, so they actually ended up pausing. Yeah, I don't think the issue was 100% figured out just yet. So just, that was a server unpause, but of course wanted to get you the action right there. Anyways, I believe we are going to still be paused here from my understanding. But with that said... All right. So, yeah, I think we're going to go to the back of the break here, guys. Again, I'll do my best to come back, though, or obviously let you guys know what's going on. So that was just a server on pause, though. Stay tuned, guys. Hopefully we'll be back soon.
Next line.
Matters so much.
such a painful way to start. Selfish acts, pretend. Hiding what we've done so far. I guess we gotta bleed.
Okay, as you can see, we are back now officially. It looks like they are going to give it a go here. Apparently, things have kind of stabilized out, and hopefully, things are going to be good to go now, of course, moving forward. But at the very least, going to resume on with what is game number one here. Again, things hopefully should be good. With that said, we are back, and kind of a quick recap as far as what's going on. So, again, welcome back. Obviously, we've been in a little bit of a pause there. But we got Sync versus Donnie. This is game one of the losers bracket finals here for what is Psycho 4. I'm Breaks MK, joined by Mini Maggot here. And, of course, our stats guy Quincy also, as always, with us. So that's kind of where we're at this game specifically. Dr. Repulsor did just get his Grimoire and Shrunken Head recently. Don has been really playing from behind for most, if not all, this game at this point. Really trying to keep in it at the very least. Ultimately give them a chance to stay in this and to possibly win it in the end. But Silhouette especially, Flensmeister, his farm very, very strong. Mickey, speaking of the one that's unfortunately been having the issues, he has been having a great game though. With that said, he's farming about 308 gold per minute right now, but has the Demonic on top of the Portal Key early on here. So there you go. Again, that's kind of a quick recap as far as where things stand. But Mini, welcome back. We did see Keeper of the Forest, by the way, get picked off. I actually did have that on screen. So
I was right. You were wrong.
That's true. Well, to be fair, I mean, they committed to a fight. Like, if you just straight out ran, then they would have lived. But they tried to turn things around.
Though Pebbles is skirting with death.
Yeah, this is a very interesting spot. Now they're going to spot them right here. Pebbles kind of charging in. He does Portal Key in. He's kind of running in right there. Stalagmite finally does come out, but he's going to be locked down initially. And now Pebbles in some trouble. Rue comes out. Eruption comes in, though, from Magmus. Pretty good timing on his part, but nobody dead on the Legion side. The heals are too much. And now Magmus in some trouble right here. He's going to be picked off. Yeah, not a fight you're looking for.
What was that initiation?
I don't know.
Like, normally Mickey is perfect with his initiation. He blinked Wolf. I mean, first of all, the initiation was slow because he saw actually all three of Dawn and he could add a three-man stun. Instead, he's behind them, actually misses the stun, and by that time, Dawn have already sort of reacted and then gone from there. Magmus Eruption tried to salvage the team fight. It just wasn't enough because, you know, the initiation was just poor, and now Dawn are going to take the Kongor, give that to Doctor as well, and he's already picked up the Shrunken Head. He's closing on the Hellflower, and my god, Zinc. They're no longer really in control of this game.
That's possibly, I mean, that's very, very possible. That's the opening that Dom was needing / looking for. I mean, now you got a token of life on Doctor. Exactly. Hell, he's getting very close to finishing the Hellflower even at the rate that he's going. So, yeah, that initiation decision, whatever the issues were, I mean, just the whole decision, the way it worked, it started off just not the best. And the numbers were in favor from Dom from the beginning, of course, with that said. So, nice deny on the middle tower right there. You sell Silhouette. That is an illusion currently. So, yeah, they're going to eventually pick it off possibly. But definitely doing some work there. And Don has to be feeling pretty good, it's safe to say, after that exchange coming out. Now, quick play, not quick play, but even a dancing blade just picked up on Silhouette. So she very likely is going to be looking to go towards a full Wingbow here.
I really like it.
Yeah, you like that here?
Because not only is it going to be good against Dr. Repulsa, who's going to be the main source of damage here for Dawn, but also because, I mean, there's no way that Dr. Repulsa can really farm a Savage Mace. I mean, whether he goes for a Savage Mace altogether, like, he's looking to go for the Hellflower here. And even if he goes for the Savage after that, he's going to be so far behind, that's going to be maybe a 15 or even 10 minute Savage Mace. And by that time, the Wingbow is already going to be picked up by a Silhouette. And not only that, they're going to be perfectly able to actually take advantage of the increased stat gain from the Wingbow that provides. And I was going to say actually that what Dawn need to do, they need to make sure that this top lane is pushed out as much as possible, because the racks here are exposed, and the perfect hero for split pushing is Silhouette. So obviously with the Wingbow as well, it's going to be increased in terms of her split pushing potential. So this top lane does need to make sure that it's pushed out, so there's no chance that Silhouette can easily backdoor this, as well as obviously bot lane and middle lane, but mainly that the top lane, because of those range racks are exposed. So
Magmus, he's actually pushing out pretty far here in the bottom lane. Yeah, he's gonna port a key away though before he ultimately possibly could have got caught right there, so it's gonna be fine. But yeah, I mean, again, even with what just happened, Mystique technically still on top as far as gold especially, but I mean, you do look at the situation right now. Doctor's token alive, 3 minutes now remaining. So we're definitely going to see Dawn here kind of look to turn it on and try to make something happen here very shortly, I'm sure, as far as a possible push. I mean, you see more and more gold being pulled up. You mentioned the portal key on Keep of the Forest, 2,200 gold more saved up on Ophelia. So there's definitely very good possibilities here.
I mean, they should definitely try and look to team fight with this token, because they've got the Shrunken Head on Dr. Repulsa, they've got the Shrunken Head on Kraken, and obviously they've got the token, so they've got that advantage. But also because if they sit back and just farm, then this Silhouette is going to easily just rip them apart in terms of split pushing. Look at the Illusions top. They're taking a lot of advantage on the map. You've got Silhouette bottom in the meantime farming all of the map. And Zinc, they've just had complete control in terms of resource control. And Dawn, what they need to do is push out, take the tier 2's mid, take the tier 2's top, because they need to regain some map control. I mean, look at the wards as well. They're quite defensive coming out from Dawn, but if you compare the wards coming out from Zing, I mean, you've got wards here up on the bottom lane, very, very aggressive here, and one on the top lane as well, incredibly offensive, just to sort of pin Dawn into their base. And Dawn, they need to break through that kind of map control that Zing have, and they've got the tools to do that. They've got, obviously, their Aegis on Dr. Repulsa. Maybe they can start with actually a pickoff on bottom lane. This is it.
They're going for it. Magmus, he's going to be locked down. Hellflower's up. They find a lot of attack to finish him off. You might be asking, wait, why was the kids reacting? Well, again, he was Hellflower, so that was just a great job jumping him in the first place, and Doctor, excellent with that item. So, I mean, that kind of goes back to, you know, as we're talking about, you know, the idea of going the Grimoire power first, definitely even still debatable to now, but at the same time, hey, it's kind of worked out in a sense. The fact that the game has actually now developed, hell, he's doing 15% more damage now as a result of it, as well as the dot that it implies, and of course, just the natural intelligence of regen that it gives you. So, overall, it's turning out to be very good. The fact that he has the Hellflower now, in fact, he's going to jump Pebbles here as well, and Pebbles going to be locked down to death right there with the Hellflower coming out. He even popped his Shrunken Head just in case at that point. So I wonder if he misclicked right there, honestly, but
it's better, because like, if Engineer or Tim has come in, it's just better to have that secured sort True. Of kill. I mean, Keeper and Kraken were sort of slow to actually rotate, but this is exactly what I was talking about. They need to regain map control, and taking the tier 1 top is incredibly important, because it restricts sort of TP ports to this top tower. I mean, you saw the top tower, the top lane. The lanes are exposed because obviously that top lane has just been able to be utilized by that tier 1 topper. Now, obviously, they're slowly regaining map control. But I mean, look at Silhouette already on the split push, starting to harass the tier 3's mid. Obviously, it's only the Illusions, but I mean, bit by bit, Dawn are slowly getting pinned into their base, and their damage are taking chip damage by chip damage. And
yeah,
they really do need to make a big team fight and stop this split push coming out from Silhouette, because at the moment, I mean, although they are getting these kills, yeah, it's important, they're still not really, you know, getting the objectives they need to really sort of close out this game.
Uh-oh.
On the top lane.
Yeah, they're going to go for it. Is that the real one? I can't even tell. We'll see if he actually dies in the process. Portal coming out, or actually TP from Kraken. He's going to say sayonara. Keeper of the Forest, actually, will accept the death. So, yeah, that was kind of curious. I mean, the team decision right there. He basically said, you know what, Keeper, you're screwed. I'm going to get out of here rather than try to commit to a kill on his Silhouette. I don't know about that.
that makes no sense. Like, first of all, Silhouette was so close to dying there. If they commit the route, that she's definitely dead, because bottom lane, actually, Dr. Pulse is going on to Magnus.
Yep, he's going to get caught. He gets the stun off. Can he actually TP away in time? No, he cannot. Hellflower comes out, and sure enough, does stop that. So,
Probos is trying his hardest to really get his team back into it. But, I mean, going back to the Silhouette top lane, Silhouette was so close to dropping there. If they commit the route there, that is actually Silhouette dead. She wouldn't have had a buyback, because obviously she bought the wing bow just before then. And then that's where they can start taking the tiers too, is to regain the map control. And I mean, if you're going to commit the release the Kraken, then you better make sure that they use the route as well. And in the end, they just didn't. And I mean, I have to say, I mean, Yellow Rex has had such a poor performance today. I mean, 1-8-3 breaky, 180 GPM. The only person with kind of good farm is Dr. Repulsor, and only 270 on Kraken. And honestly, it's not enough for Dawn to be taking this game if they can only just have Probust, but he's definitely going to try his hardest. Illusion Silhouette here is going to be fine.
I mean, this goes back to earlier. Remember the melee racks? They were actually able to prevent the melee racks from going down, but look what he's doing. Yeah, he's killing the range racks in the end, and he gets on out of there. So range racks, a lot less armor, obviously, able to burst it down quicker. And he takes it. And I mean, at this point, you could argue that range, I mean, hell, just getting the range tracked in itself is honestly pretty damn good.
No, it's a big deal. And this is what I was trying to say to you, a couple of minutes ago. They need to make sure that this push, this top lane is pushed, because it will stop, Flensmeister from doing that. Instead, they go for a gank on an Illusion Silhouette. They commit a lot of resources there. The top lane isn't pushed out, and as a result, Flensmark can easily just rotate in and take the top racks, and they have a lot of mobile heroes, particularly the Dr. Repulsor, but it's just not mobile enough to really punish the split push here from Flensmeister. And they're just slowly but surely just getting pinned in bit by bit, and when the Toga or when Konga comes up again, most likely it's going to be in favor of Hellbomb because of this map control breaking.
Yeah. Well, hey, speaking of map control right here, the Hellborn team all kind of inside the Legion jungle to an extent, taking some farm where they can. You do see Dawn going to start scouting it out, sending out the tree dogs, getting some information as far as what's going on. Obviously, Token of Life has worn off well by now. You got Congor should be resurrecting here in the near future. Speaking of Doctor, by the way, how about this decision? Actually picks up a plate mail to go to an eventual Frostfield play. Yeah, you like that decision?
I mean, I like it because obviously he needs some kind of physical presence against Silhouette. But at the same time, he needs a Savage Mace. He's going to get Silhouette, and the only way you can really perfectly do damage against, obviously, the 30% of evasion is the Savage Mace. So it's decent because, I mean, he's being incredibly mobile with his mana, obviously, and the extra intelligence from Frostfall player is good, and obviously it's going to be useful against the physical presence. But at the same time, that last item has to be a Savage Mace here coming out from Doctor if they want to really contest Silhouette in the late game.
Yeah. That makes too much sense here. I mean, especially with that wing bow, yeah, there's just no reason why Savage... I mean, we have seen the Doctor Savage Mace before, too. It's definitely not out of the question. And,
I think Balthazar used to get it all the time.
Yeah. Well, that's what I was going to say. I'm trying to think of who exactly maybe we saw it on. But, yeah, and again, it just makes sense. So if they want a chance of winning in the late game, that would be the case there. So how about this? 3,800 gold saved up on Iceland Gogo playing Ophelia. So not often you see Ophelia just saving up so much gold, especially when she only has a Ring of the Sorcery Astrolabe. I mean, I'm trying to think what possibly could she be. They don't have a Ring of the Teacher. They do on Keeper.
They need Barrier.
Okay.
A lot, because there's so much AoE, and although they've got Shrungens on Doctor and Keeper Kraken. And so I've got to cut you off there, Breaky. Look at Silhouette, what he's doing. He's walking three and four different times in this bottom lane to try and push out the lane, and he's cutting the lane completely. And this is what I mean. To be fair, this is the first time, and he's actually going for the all in 2-3 bottom.
Doctor Flannan, though, but exactly, he ports out to his illusion, and is like, yeah, I'm just fine. Actually, that's my illusion there. So he's just gonna leave it.
Yeah, I have to admit though. I mean, we have seen a lot of great Silhouette players over the times. You've got a lot, obviously, Marcus Moy, Probost comes to mind as well, obviously. But Flensmeister and Team Zinc are the first team that really have utilized Silhouette's split-pushing potential. And I think this is exactly the way you're meant to play Silhouette. She's got an incredibly heavy stat items, the Geomancer's Bane, the Nullstone, and the Wingbow. So, obviously, her illusions are going to take the most amount of advantages. And that's the biggest thing about split-pushing. But also, she's really being less focused about killing heroes and being involved in team fights, but more at sort of pressuring the lanes. Of she took the range racks top and try to take the tier 3 bottom, and I love the way that Silhouette is being played here, because I mean, in all of Hon's history, there hasn't been a lot of strategies involving split push, but I mean, with this Silhouette pickup, we are starting to see the split push potential here, and it's a little bit scary because Dawn at the moment, outside of Dr. Repulsor, they have no kind of mobility to really punish Silhouette. And I mean, they've got Portal Key on Kraken, but it's just not enough. And Silhouette, I mean, if you think about it, like, for the last 30 minutes, Dawn haven't actually stepped onto the Hellborn side of the map, and that's because of split pushing from Silhouette. So,
yeah.
Great play card from Flensmaster here. So.
Yeah, and you can say Dr. Pulse, but at the same time, you know, that's where the Nullstone definitely comes into play. That at least gives him enough time to ideally react if he's going to be jumped by something like that Dr.
Exactly.
Pulse.
Yeah.
As we kind of saw at that bottom lane. So he's actually going to group up with Engineer right here and get the Energizer buff on him to kind of see if they can maybe catch somebody. But as you can see, that's not going to be happening. I mean, speaking of split pushing potential, Keeper the Force also usually pretty good at that.
On
but exactly. He's
again.
Going right back in behind the creep wave. He's going to go right for the tower here. Using the tree grapple, and it's like, so Dawn, like, they can't even really move at this point.
Exactly.
They're constantly having to get back.
And they're going to take the tier 3 bottom as well, and there's nothing they can do. Like, I said they haven't really been able to move on side of the Hellborn, side of the racks, and that's because they can't, because the split from Silhouette is just too much. But what they need to do is somehow kill Silhouette, try and maybe go for a bait or some kind of sort of gank potential and try and like make a trap for her. If you kill Silhouette, that's when you can start pushing outside of the base, take the tier 2's top, take the tier 2's mid, even go for Conga. But they need to make sure that they can kill Silhouette, because he is the one that's creating so much space for Zinc here. The other heroes are just there for a potential team fight, and in the meantime, they've just been farming their own jungle while Silhouette has been pushing every single lane. I mean, we talk about how Flensmeister hasn't had too much of an impact in sort of the series in terms of Zinc in general, because obviously maybe the heroes he's been playing, I think he was 4th GPM one of those cycles, but I mean, this game in particular, it's been all Flensmeister today.
Absolutely.
And he's been playing absolutely fantastic. I mean, it's really hard to sort of get into the mindset of how the game is going, but I can assure you that Dawn are getting incredibly annoyed by Flensmeister and the split pushing potential, because every single time Dawn try and progress and, you know, group as fiver and take a team fight, its Silhouette is there just to really sort of keep them guessing it and making sure they have to return into their base. I mean, look at what he's doing. He's actually going into the trees here on the left side, opening some kind of path for himself to, you know, to split push even better. He's going to start going onto the melee racks, and look how fast he takes it down.
Yeah, they have to react. They get here.
50%.
It's like
that's
so
illusions only.
Yep.
What can they do?
I mean, they have to obviously pick them out before it goes down, which they are, so a little bit of reach will start kicking in, but that's one more of those situations right there, which is going to be up pretty quickly for Flensmeister, and that melee rash will be picked off. So it's almost like Dawn has to be not – well, there's two things. One, everyone has to be keeping a TP, especially something like the Dr. Pulsar. I mean, ideally you should be doing that anyways, but making sure that you always have that. And then – or, yeah, something like a Pulsar, you could argue, actually could be pretty important at this point. Middle lane, those are just illusions, actually. So.
But look, I mean, Dawn have had enough with this split mission. They're going to go as five, but look at Flensmeister. He's already on the ball. I mean, I honestly just can't... Actually, Pebbles, that's an illusion, don't worry. But I can't honestly give enough credit to Flensmeister, because single-handedly, like, he's playing 1v5 while his team's just farms. Like, I mean, it honestly isn't. And if you look at the gold... like, if we had gold grass, for example, you'd see that slowly but surely that Sync are increasing their farm because of the sort of map control they've been having. The Sync have been able to farm their own woods while Flensmeister pushes in every single lane. It looks like they're going to take the tier 2 top. But I mean, already look at Flensmeister. He's actually starting on the range tracks, bottom lane.
Yep, he's going down there. Going to try to drop that real quickly so they get the middle secondary tower. But at what cost here? We do see TPs coming in. Again, those aren't just illusions for the time being. But even with being the illusions, he's not going to be able to kill them even close to quick enough. So that's going to easily be a range. He even uses release the Kraken right there. I mean, that tells you something, if anything, the fact that they're just here using ultimate cooldowns to try to prevent illusions from dropping their barracks. So you are right. I mean, it's the first time I do feel like that we are seeing the true potential of Silhouette.
I mean, in Dota, this is quite common, but I've never honestly seen it in Honan, and this is exactly how it's been playing. And Flensmeister is honestly executing this strategy perfectly. And Dawn, they just don't know how to really deal with it. The only way, like I said before, that they need to deal with it is to somehow kill Silhouette. But with the Nullstone, with the Portal Key, it is so hard to kill him. The only way they can really do it is if they have the... Oh, Kizzy just quits because he's had enough, but... most likely, pause? No.
Well, they can't pause. They're out of pauses, so... He's just doing a reconnect, I guess. So.
Dawn are going to go for a Kongor, perhaps? No, but no. One thing that they need to do, though, is honestly, they need to make sure that Keeper of the Forest is ready with his root, because if he roots, Silhouette, I don't know if you knew this, but he can't actually swap back to his ultimate or to his illusions if the Keeper of the Root is used. So they need to sort of try and bait out the split push from Silhouette, use the root, use the Hellfire from Dr. Pulsar, kill Silhouette, and then they can start on it, because look at Silhouette, he's taking the melee back's bottom. They're actually committing the Kraken to a push, but...
You see, that the problem with that, though, I'm pretty sure he's honestly just... porting out. Actually, he ports in right here, and he's going to make sure the Melee Rex goes down. Now he ports right back out. It's such a low cooldown at this point that he's still going to get the Melee Rex right there. You do see they're pushing the bottom lane. This is ridiculous, man. I mean, so much is going on. Magmus and Engineer actually do fall. In a sense, we're kind of having a base race here, it looks like. Pebbles and Tempest, they're going middle. I think Dawn's almost like, yeah, but they can't. They can't base race. They have to get tagged.
Last game already.
I mean, it's not 100% over, but here we go. Initiation. That is the real Silhouette. We're going to see Mega Creeps here any second pop up as Tempest is going to get picked off. And there we go. Mega Creeps is going to spawn. Pebbles, he gets out of there. And Silhouette should be fine. So it's like if you're Dawn, you just got Mega Creeped, even though momentum, you think we're looking pretty good for you. They catch Silhouette.
Yeah.
Oh, this is actually a pretty big deal. I mean, if they can finish her off, but no, the follow up.
And I mean, I said it time and time again, but they need to make sure Keeper Root is there, because it's the only thing that's going to stop Silhouette from swapping out. The Hellfly is not going to be quick enough, because he has the Portal Key and the Nullstone. And, I mean, we talk about how Keeper hasn't had a great game, but, I mean, you have to really be using that Root to really focus down Silhouette, because at the moment, it's been 1v5 against Silhouette. They're going all in on the push now.
Yeah, they have to.
That's the only play they've got to make.
But absolutely.
Honestly, I mean, Yellow Rexar really needs to improve his game for game two, because it really hasn't impressed me this game.
Well, I mean, you see he's up there at the front lines, but obviously his team's all busy trying to kill these Mega Creeps back here, and you can just see the power of them. Doctor flies in, they say, screw it, we got to make something happen now. They jump Pebbles. Pebbles going to be locked up. Tabitha on him, it comes out. It is going to be stopped by Ophelia right there, it looks like. Doctor Pulsar, though, he's not going to be able to do enough in the end. I mean, he's still flying around, trying to pick people off. He gets Magnus killed, but buyback's definitely going to be too strong in the end, and we're going to see GG's coming out here. He gets a hat trick, actually, an immortal streak for ProBusk. Are you kidding me? He actually got an immortal streak.
He's got a mortal, and they're going to lose, man. Like,
oh, that's ridiculous. That is ridiculous. I mean, they're not giving it just yet, but it's like that's the power of Mega Creeps right there. Yeah, he actually does come back with the post-haste. Looking to get some kills and actually trying to open up a window. But right now, he is by himself, and that's not a fight he is going to win, no matter how farmed he is. So they're going to try to chase him down. And very likely are, because he is getting very low on mana here. And, yeah, he's going to be caught out, and this should do it. And he will be picked off. So he does have another buyback, I think. Yeah, he actually has another buyback, which he does immediately.
GG, man.
But,
GG.
Yeah, they know it's just too much. So people are going to be screaming backdoor and everything, but we've talked about it so many times. It's like... You know, you do what it takes to win. There's no rules against it. That is strategy, exactly.
It's a strategy.
And they made it work.
If you think about it, all of the strategy, to me, has been kind of a little bit personally boring. I love this kind of strategy, because all the strategy that's been played in terms of Hon is just either heavy push or heavy teamfight. You know, the teamfight is still going on, actually, but looks like the Shrine's going to be dropping us likely.
Yeah, they're kind of, this is that overtime phase, you know, just having fun. They're not actually continuing, not sure why, but... in the old-fashioned way, I guess.
But yeah, just going back to it, though, I mean, there's been always a lot of team fight and a lot of push, but two strategies that have kind of been disregarded is the sort of late-game split push and sort of heavy gank and sort of late-game in that respect. And finally, we're sort of seeing this sort of split push strategy come in, and it's absolutely dominated Dawn, because, like I said, when Shrunken Heads were being...